Oh, I want to sleep.
Amen, I do. Let's try it on you, brother.
As I travel through this land, singing as I go, mornings of the Calvary, to the realms of glory.
Oh,
4. I can't feel at home in this world anymore. This world is not my home.
Tonight.
Amen.
I want to be ready.
Amen.
I want to get to where I want to be, just like, I don't want to feel at home in this place, Brother Wallace, you know. It's like when you go on vacation, you know, sometimes you just want to go home.
That's right.
I feel like home. That's the way I feel tonight. We're going to give you an opportunity to testify. I know God's been good to each and every one of us here tonight. And you that want to sing, go ahead and be getting your song ready. So who will be first to start it off?
Brother Bill, I want to say I love the Lord. And much was when I got up early and carried that prayer clock. And she was sitting in her chair, 9 o'clock, and she hadn't put on no clothes or anything. But anyway, I went in and talked to her for a few minutes, and I gave her the prayer clock. And she kind of hung her head, and she started crying. And she said, you know, she said, I can tell you what, she says, and this is true, she said, you remember years ago, she said, when I was in the hospital, and she said, and they told me that I had a lot of female problems, and I would have to have surgery to correct all that and everything, and I said, yeah. She said, I was laying there, and she said, this little black lady come in, and said, she anointed me with oil. And said, let me just put that oil right there. And I said, I know. And she said, and you know what? She said, I went home. She said, I never had another female problem.
Hallelujah.
She said, I was at church one night. She said, I was walking around. She said, and my knee was just, she said, killing me. She said, I had fell on it. It was hurting. And she said, Brother Kenneth Johnson said, what's wrong with your knee, Sister Sarah? Said, she said, I fell on it. Said, he said, all right. And he said, come over there and lay his hand on it. And they started praying. Got up the next morning, moved out of bed. So she said, I know prayer works.
Amen.
And she just said, I want to thank you. And I just want to say that I thank the Lord for the faith. Because, you know, she's got a good walk with him, Brother Dale.
Yes.
She's been faithful. She's been faithful for years. And, you know, I pray to God, she's been faithful.
Yes.
Just bring that up as a memorial in front of you.
Yes.
And y'all just keep reading prayers. And I just thank the Lord that he saved my soul and lifted me up.
Amen. Amen. Great testimony. Great testimony. Who will be next?
I love the Lord.
Bless him tonight.
I thank him for all of his goodness to me, and thank him for his mercy. Thank him most of all for dying on the cross.
Yes.
Amen.
You know, this world is not our home anymore. Mm-mm. And you know, it's a weary place to live. You know, you have so much going on now, and you think about so many things that can pull you down if you just let it, you know. And you stop and think about, you know, Lord, you know, sometimes you just say, come Lord, you know.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And the song that says, wait a little longer, please Jesus, you know, because I want to get my family in, right, and my friends in and loved ones in, you know. And that's just something that every day we need to strive to say, Lord, yeah, wait a little longer, and hopefully and pray that, you know, that people can get more in. You yeah know, and I want to stay true to the Lord. I want to stay prayed up any way possible that I can.
Yes, amen.
I want to serve him the best I can. I fail him every day.
We all do.
Lots of failures. And I just pray, though, that you know, the Lord is faithful to forgive. And he's going to be with us and go with us. And he understands,
amen.
I think, you know, when you make blunders, you know, you maybe not sinning, but you make mistakes.
Right.
And life, but he's faithful to forgive.
Amen. Amen.
I just pray that I can stay prayed up, you know, and you know, to see my loved ones in, you know.
Yes.
And if not, then I have the peace, you know, and I say, Lord,
come on.
If I don't live to see them,
they're still coming.
The world, you know, God comes before that. I know that I'm going to see them in heaven.
Yes.
Because I just know that they're going to get to be saved.
Yes.
I'm going to see them there. And that's all I can dwell on.
Yes.
I think about that. I can't let my guard down. I can't stop praying.
Amen.
I have to continue. And you know, for that every day, you know. But I thank him and I love him for all of his time.
You know, I thought as she was testifying in Matthew 24, Jesus begins to reveal some of the things that will be occurring right before his coming. Some of those things we're living in right now, earthquakes and diverse places, means many places, nation against nation, kingdom against kingdom. We see that. That doesn't mean like Iran against Saudi Arabia. It means races against one another. We see that in America like we haven't seen in many, many years. But we are not to get all caught up in it, as Sister Jewel made mention. The Bible said, Jesus said, when you see these things appearing or approaching, look up.
Yeah.
For your redemption draweth nigh. That's to be a sign for us. It's kind of like Brother Wallace headed home, and you see them signs that say so many miles to home, you know, and as you're getting closer, we're not to worry, Aunt Kat, because we know that whatever we commit into His hands. I think so many times the mothers that are here with lost loved ones and children especially, how to have that faith and confidence and know that God is faithful when you put them on that altar. I've seen it with my own grandparents, how that God was faithful to Sheila. They were dead many years, but God has saved every one of them. The only last one living is Aunt Savannah Lee, and I know without a shadow of doubt she's ready to meet God.
Amen.
So all seven of their children, they'll see again in glory. Amen. But they left here, Linda, with the promise. They left here with the promise. And Aunt Candy, I know if He did it for them, He'll do it for me. I've got children tonight that are unsaved. And got some that are not on fire like they need to be. But I believe I put them into God's hands, and He's going to bring them in. If I live faithful to God and leave this world holding that nail scarred hand, then I believe He's going to be faithful and bring them in. Who'll be next?
Brother Dale, I love the Lord tonight.
Yes,
you know, thank you so much for hearing and answering my prayer.
Yes.
I was a little bit aggravated with myself. I had to go back to Dr. Burroughs Wednesday because I missed my appointment. I had to reschedule it when I went to stay with my son. And I was sitting there, you know, and you feel this little shaky, fearful feeling. Because I had to talk to him about all these places that's coming.
Right.
Only its age spots is what it is. But he took care of about 12 of them. I can't even get out of his yard. I got a big old head in, and my granddaughter went and bought me one.
It's your sombrero.
That's what he told me I needed. He said, but you know, Miss Catherine, I've been your doctor ever since I've been in practice, and he said, I have never told any of my patients this. He said, and I don't know what you're going to think about me, I've got to go and have this bald spot burned because I got moles on top of my head. I cannot wear a hat or a cap or anything. And he said, and you know, I cannot wear my wedding ring or my class ring. And said, when I proposed to my wife, I had to make sure that she would marry me without wearing the wedding ring. He said, that's really crazy. I said, well, what did she say? He said, well, she told me, yeah, she loved me enough, but she sure would like for him to wear the wedding ring. And he said, well, I can't tolerate it. I just can't stand it. He said, too, it's funny when you get to talking. He said, and I sweat like a horse. I said, I can't wear no ring, you know. He said, I paid $400 for my ring, and I can't have never even been able to wear it. But he said, you come on back to my little lab, I'll fix you, fix your face. Boy, if I ain't got a mess. And it has burned. I can't walk outside my door hardly because the heat of the sun burns. But y'all pray that they're
yeah,
on the
ain't going to get better.
Away, you know, because I've got the Lord too that's got to come off.
God take care
he
of them.
He said, one. You know, let's see. He said, I believe you're about 70-something. I said, yes. Yeah. And he said, well, probably about 60 years. You've been running around in this sun, and this is what that's doing. It's damage from the sun.
Well,
you got age spot.
What happened to him?
Yeah.
Stay in the sun.
song they want to sing?
Well, they like to say, I love the Lord at night. That song is something like, I can't feel at home.
Amen.
My brother that passed away at 18 months old, I didn't get to see him. They told me after the song that they sung at his funeral. And you know, I believe tonight that if I do the very best I can, I might.
Yes.
Sister Jewel and I stumble and fall. But if I can stay prayed up, I believe I'm going to get to see my brother.
Yes, sir.
And I believe I'm going to know who he is.
Yes, sir, you will.
And I say this not jokingly, I say this with all honesty. He must have got most of the music talent in our family, because they said there was one or two songs that he could sing all the way through at 18 months old and carry the tune right with it and everything. But God decided to take him home.
Amen. Let him sing in glory.
And one day, he's going to take us home as well, isn't
he? Amen.
And I appreciate him. I love him so much for going to the cross for me. Y'all just pray for him.
Amen.
Amen. Anybody else tonight?
Brother Dale, I want to say I love the Lord and thank him for what he's done for me in life. And you know what he's going to do for us, because I'm still holding on to that.
Holding on. Amen.
For us. And you know, also, you know, I know God's going to save my brother, because I've been really been praying for my brother. He's been talking to me. And you know, I told him, I said, Mike, you've got to get some things out of your heart to make it seem on. And he said, listen to me. And I hope that he'll listen and make everything right that he's supposed to. Because my mama's prayer is not going to
Oh, yeah. She prayed a many a prayer.
Because he's already working on the day. So I know they're not going to go unheard. But y'all just keep me in your prayers. And, you know, maybe some way I can touch my brother.
Amen. God open up the doors.
And, you know, he's put a man in his life, you know, that really talks to him about. And he listens, but he just don't got their head. But y'all just keep them all in your prayer, even to Carolyn. Because Carolyn wants to know
it's
all about the Lord. We've been having the Holy Ghost, speaking in tongues, and I know you're going to come back.
Amen. Amen.
And y'all just keep them in your prayers.
Anybody
else? I'm going to praise the Lord for Daddy. We took him, was it Monday or Tuesday? Monday.
Yeah.
He down there and seen Dr. Murphy. He had to make a trip to Mobile before he started treating him up here, you know. Got down there and they done EKG and said that, it, you know, showed his AFib on there messing up a little bit. But he said mostly that can be controlled with medicine, that AFib stuff. And they had put him on three different kind of heart pills, right? And it had his heart rate down to like 45, which is way too low. And so they took one away from him, and they're going to see how that does. And then in 3 weeks, he'll see him up here. So we're just going to be praying that the heart's back in rhythm. Everything will be good to go. So I thank God for that report.
Also, I'm praying for us, too, because I was making the report for another.
Yeah, he's got a place that's come on his lip. Daddy has a lot of skin cancer. He's had to have removed it. Got something dark that's come right up here on the lip and it don't look right. So he likes to go to that. He said he's sick of doctors.
Yeah, he's like a child with his son-in-law over there. He's been trying to get
you haven't heard him and Dale in the heart doctor waiting room. Dale's son will go get the car and get ready to run, Daddy. Because Daddy don't like to wait.
Got a heavy mind. Any others?
Yeah. Now I thought a lot in this past week of how we have really improved against the I go back to even before Cindy was born and knew that I was standing at death's door. Blood poison set up. They didn't think I'd live. They didn't think my baby would live. But I can sit here tonight and say that God brought me through it.
Yes.
And I had a little praying ankle. Oh my goodness, that little woman could pray. And when I was hurt so bad, she was right there beside me praying. You know, and I was praying to die, and she was praying for me to live. And I needed to, my dad right then, I bust the hell out of it. But I was hurting so bad, I didn't care. But, you know, I thank God that we're praying.
Amen.
And, you know, it's been so much in the last few years that it's almost like your brain can't even comprehend what all that we have been through and what all that we're still going through. But I know one thing, it's made me a lot stronger person than I've ever been.
That's
and
for
I
sure.
know it's made me closer to God than I've ever been.
Amen.
Because I've learned to lean on Him. We can lean on each other, but to lean on God, He's not going to let us
down. Amen.
He never has and never will.
Never will.
And I just, you know, there's just not enough words to even praise Him enough.
You're right.
For what He has done in my family. But y'all just pray for me because truly I do want to make heaven my home. And I thank you every day for going to that cross for me.
Anybody else?
I want to say I love the Lord tonight, and I thank Him for keeping us safe when we hit the deer last night and allowing us to be able to still drive the car because it could have very well took the car completely out. So I just want to thank Him for that.
Amen.
Did you see them band things just pulls it together like Herman's got a mind?
We got plenty of them. It's held together with zip ties now.
That's what we got.
That's what's holding that green band together.
It sure is.
Zip ties. The headlights shining up in the tree.
I did like going to the night with the coons up in there. Up there in the trees. They go down the road. They can see them in the trees.
I love the Lord tonight.
Blessing God.
And I'm happy to be here.
Yes.
I'm blessed in so many ways.
Amen.
But I let Him know every day.
Amen.
That's right.
And I'm thankful.
Right. Amen.
And I had a big, fast Buick years ago. That thing would had a straight eight in it, a standard transmission. And I hit a deer down yonder at Huckford. I run him about, I don't know, 60, 70 mile an hour, and he just ripped that whole side of that Buick.
Yeah.
I drove that thing for about 2 years.
Still running. Hey, amen. That is a scary thing though when you see them coming in.
Ain't nowhere to go.
Anybody else? I know God's been good to every one of us.
Amen.
Amen. Anybody want to sing tonight?
You do.
Who? You say you do?
I said you do.
You do.
You do, that's right.
Y'all want to come help you?
Who comes first?
Y'all want to come help you?
I'm going to let them help you.
Who? Hey, Kat, let's sing your song. Come on, you know it by heart. Friend, don't worry about this evening, but I carry to travel. you want to testify.
Don't miss your opportunity. Because I know God's been good to every one of you.
Amen.
I love the Lord tonight. I thank Him for everything He's done for me.
Bless our God.
Amen.
That's it.
Hallelujah.
Well, that leaves two here that ain't testified. Y'all want me to draft y'all?
Well, I'm thankful for everything God's done for me and
bless them God
for watching over me and helping me, just helping me every day.
Amen.
Amen.
God. We got one left.
I love the Lord tonight and I thank Him for protecting us yesterday and all that He does for us.
Bless Him God.
Amen. Glory to the Lord. Bible said we're made overcomers by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony.
It's good to be in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Wednesday before last, I started a little Bible study. I didn't know whether Brother Edwin would continue his Bible study on Wednesday night or not. Then Daniel. And I really thought about continuing on with that tonight, but God dropped something in my spirit today. I just got to share it. That's all there is to it. That's what He wants me to do. So.
Amen. Go ahead, brother.
I won't hold y'all no longer than He holds me tonight. You got your Bibles with you, and I certainly pray that you do. Turn to Exodus chapter 3. Listen to the testimony tonight. Confirm what God has laid on my heart. Bring to you tonight. I got to build a little foundation here with Moses.
Come on.
Exodus chapter 3, verse 10. This is still what God was talking to Moses at the burning bush. We all know about the burning bush because it wasn't nothing in that day back in that area to see a bush just explode and catch on fire, so to speak.
Right.
I don't know if you call that spontaneous combustion or what. Yeah. But the thing, the rare thing was, this bush didn't burn up.
Amen.
And you know, everybody, there's been a lot of people try to say, well, them bushes over there catch fire like that all the time. Well, they do, but they all burn up. This one didn't. But anyway, Exodus chapter 3, verse, starting with verse 10. God was talking to Moses and said, come now, therefore, I will send thee unto Pharaoh, that thou mayest bring forth my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt. And Moses said unto God, who am I that I should go unto Pharaoh and that I should bring forth the children of Israel out of Egypt? And he said, certainly I will be with thee, and this shall be a token unto thee that I have sent thee. When thou hast brought forth the people out of Egypt, ye shall serve God upon this mountain. And Moses said unto God, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and shall say unto them, the God of your fathers has sent me unto you, and they shall say to me, what is his name? What shall I say unto them? And God said unto Moses, I am that I am.
Amen.
And he said, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel, I am, has sent me unto you. My Heavenly Father, I thank you for your word tonight, Lord God. Lord, I ask you for the anointing tonight, because I can preach this the way you've been giving it to me today, Lord. I need all I can get from you tonight, Lord God. I need the Holy Ghost to fill my mouth with words, Lord, and let Him speak through me. I ask you to bless each and every one that's here tonight. Anoint our ears that we can receive the word and that we can go forth like you would want us to go forth with it, Lord God. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. You may be seated. Keep your Bibles open because we're going to go to a few more places. But what God has dropped in my spirit is it's time for the church to stand up to the devil. Brother Dale has went about, I think, three or four Wednesday nights studying on our weapons of our warfare.
Amen.
And I think that was, I really believe tonight, I know Brother Dale don't get us get up here cutting and take something he wants to study and do it. God needs him to do it.
Yes.
And God was leading up to this message tonight, Brother Dale.
Amen.
It's time that we stood up to the devil and tell him, let our people go.
Amen.
Let our children go.
Amen. Come on.
let our loved ones go. It's been tested no money tonight. Everybody's wanting to bring their loved ones in. Wait a little while longer. Well, it's time for the church to stand up, face up to the devil, and say, let my people go. So they can come back to the house of God and serve Him like they're supposed to.
Amen.
And I want to tell you something tonight. It's not an easy battle. It's not an easy battle. You ain't going to just tell Him one time and it's going to be over with. Can I tell you that tonight? It tells us all the way through Exodus here how many times Moses had to go before Pharaoh. One time in chapter 10, I believe, chapter 8. You want to turn there for just a quick verse? Verse 1, it said, and the Lord spake unto Moses, go unto Pharaoh and say unto him, thus saith the Lord, let my people go that they may serve me. Uh-huh. I want to tell you, you have to tell him time and time and time again. If the church in whole, a church all over today, would stand up to the devil and say, let my people go in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, he would have to let them go. But if the whole church of the world don't want to do that, this little church right here needs to be doing it.
Yes, amen.
Don't let us fall in a trend with other churches that say, well, I'm scared to talk to the devil like that. Well, I tell you what, if you got the Holy Ghost in you tonight, you don't need to be scared to talk to the devil like that. You need to know that you got the power to tell him in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth to let your children and grandchildren go tonight.
Amen.
To let your loved ones go. Get away from them. Our problem is we sit back, and I'm going to go ahead and preach this. If you get mad at me, meet me at the door at the end and love me, all right? We have been too long sitting on the pews, whining and crying about our loved ones being lost. Let's do something about it.
Amen.
Let's stand up to the devil tonight in the name of Jesus Christ and tell him to let our people go. Because I'm going to tell you something. We ain't got much longer to get them in. I said, we ain't got much longer to get them in.
Amen.
Sister Kathy, if we don't stand in that gap, ain't nobody else going to do it.
Come on, preach or something.
Melinda, I got a feeling. Whew. I said, I got a feeling tonight that if we stand up to the devil, you and I tonight, we stand up to the devil and say in the name of Jesus Christ, let our children and grandchildren go.
Lord,
let them go. You got to let them go.
Yes.
If it don't happen tonight, let's do it again tomorrow.
Come on, brother.
If it don't happen then, let's do it again the next day. If it don't happen then, let's do it the next day because he got to let them go. Pharaoh said he wasn't going to let the children of Israel go. Over in verse 20, and the Lord said unto Moses, rise up early in the morning and stand before Pharaoh. Lo, he cometh forth to the water, and say unto him, thus saith the Lord, let my people go, that they may serve me. And if the devil wants to say, well, who do you think you are? Just tell him, say, the I am sent me.
Amen.
Woo, I said, tell him the I am sent me. Jehovah God sent me and said in the name of Jesus Christ, let my children go.
Amen.
So they can come back to the house of God where they belong and serve him. Each and every one of them should be sitting on these pews tonight. And we sit back and let the devil put doubt and worry into our hearts. And we've done, all of us, just about all of us, you got a few years, I will too. You done got gray-headed from it. That's not for y'all. Y'all got a while to go.
I raised my hand.
We are sitting on it. So much power in this little church.
Amen,
that we can light up New York City in a blackout if we just try it, if we just use it.
Let God use it. Come on. Help me, Lord.
Chapter 9, verse 1. Then the Lord said unto Moses, go in unto Pharaoh and tell him, thus saith the Lord God of the Hebrews, let my people go that they may serve me. Our problem is we want it, as Brother David said, we want it like a microwave. We want to punch a button and do it right then.
Yeah.
We ain't got the stay power no more that we used to have. We used to have stay power in the church. Stay in the altar until somebody got prayed through until 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning.
Amen. Preach.
Yeah. Them old timers used to stay there at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. They'd be going to work at 5. Let a revival break out. I'm talking about true Holy Ghost revival here.
Amen.
They work from sun up to sundown and go to revival at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning.
Yes, they would.
And have just as much energy the next day as the next man had if he had 8 hours sleep.
Yes, sir.
Woo, I know what I'm talking about, church. I might not be the smartest person in the world in the past, but I know what I'm talking about tonight.
Yes, sir.
Because I know what the Word of God says. The God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, said, let my people go. Who can defeat it tonight? I feel the Holy Ghost in this place tonight. I feel the Holy Ghost is just wanting to bust open in here tonight and try to show you just how much power you got when it comes to your loved ones. Chapter 9, verse 13. I'm talking about stay power. I ain't got to go through all the plagues. Y'all know all about them. I'm just going through the time that God told Moses to go do it. And the Lord said. Woo, can you hear him? Listen close tonight. The Lord said, let my people go.
Yes.
The Lord said, devil, let my children go. So they can come back to the house and serve me. The Lord said unto Moses, rise up early in the morning and stand before Pharaoh and say unto him, thus saith the Lord God of the Hebrews, let my people go. Whew. Do you understand where I'm coming from tonight?
Come on, brother.
I know what the devil's telling you tonight. The same thing he was telling me on that lawnmower today when God was putting this in my spirit. You ain't can't do this. You just trying to get people hyped up. I ain't wanting you hyped up. I'm wanting you ready to go to work.
Amen.
I'm wanting you ready to fight.
Ready to go to work.
Because this is a fight we're in. It's not no everyday play period. The battleground's been set. It's our children, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren, our husbands, our wives, our loved ones, our nieces, our nephews. That's who's laying on this battleground I'm looking at right now.
Yes.
Because we have not stood up to the devil. He starts warning us. We just want to... The old dog just tuck our tail between our legs and run.
Come on, preach it to us now.
Ain't nowhere in the Bible God told you to run from the devil.
Nowhere.
If you find it, I want you to show it to me because it ain't in my Bible. Let me ask you a question. If you've seen somebody with a knife in one of your children's throat, what would you do? You would claw and dig and scrape and just let him cut your throat before you let him cut your child's throat. Well, why are you sitting down letting the devil drag him to hell for?
That's right.
Does anybody understand what I'm trying to preach here tonight? I'm talking about our loved ones that's so dear and precious to us. I ain't never been a real bad person about fighting and stuff. I've been in a few. Would you let somebody touch one of our girls?
Come on.
Daddy'd be over there. Papa would be there, Linda. But yet I'm sitting still letting the devil take them to hell.
Come on.
It's time for us to wake up. It's time for us to see there's a battle going on. Chapter 10, verse 3. Are you tired of telling the devil to let your children go yet?
Come on.
Moses was standing face to face with him.
Yeah, he was.
You say, well, Pharaoh was a man. Yeah, but he was full of the devil.
Amen.
He was standing face to face with the devil. Time after time after time. Moses and Aaron came in unto Pharaoh and said unto him, Thus saith the God of the Hebrews, How long wilt thou refuse to humble thyself before me? Let my people go that they may serve me. Yes. Don't you understand what God's trying to tell us today? We got to fight for our children to get them back into this house of God so they can serve Him instead of serving the world that they're in right now. Well, Brother Herman, I prayed. Have you really fought the battle yet?
Come on.
Have you really stood up and said, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, devil, let my children go? I said, boy, Brother Herman, you just gone crazy tonight.
Fix it, brother. We need it.
If I'm crazy, if my word is right, if I'm crazy, God made me that way, and He didn't make me no crazy person. Did you hear what I said? I'm telling you something, God dealt with me for about 2 hours today with mounting up down a lawnmower. And over and over and over, He said, tell him to go tell the devil to let the people go. Because yes. He's not supposed to have them. I'm supposed to have them.
Amen.
I need warriors. I need warriors that will stand up and intercede and stand in the gap for their loved ones. I need them to tell the devil something. Well, I don't know about talking to the devil like that. You know, we just humans. Over in Mark chapter 16, if you want to turn there, please do. If not, remember the verses. Starting with verse 14 to the end of the book of Mark. Afterward, I'm fixing to show you where you got the power, all right? I'm fixing to show you. If you tell me you ain't got the power, you either ain't got the Holy Ghost in you, you're not saved, or you calling Jesus a liar.
Come on now.
Because if you're saved tonight, listen. Afterward, He appeared under the 11 as they sat at meat. Y'all, excuse me just a minute. Upbraided them with their unbelief and hardness of heart. Oh, we've had so much unbelief. And we've let the devil harden our hearts.
Amen.
We're so angry right now, and you know who you're angry at? You're actually angry with God. You might as well confess it tonight. But I don't know why God is letting my children go like they go. Maybe it's because you ain't stood up and thought. You ever thought about that? Because they believed not them which had seen Him after He was risen. And He said unto them, now this is Jesus talking, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that, now listen, I know you've heard it before. A lot of church still preaches it. Well, now all this stuff was for just the disciples. Guess what you are tonight? You're saved. You're a disciple of Christ. And preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth. He didn't say the disciples. He didn't say, Peter, if you believe. Right. He said, he that believeth. That means he or she, okay?
Amen.
Shall be saved. And is baptized shall be saved. But he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. Them that believe. Not just Peter, John, and Paul, and all them.
Amen.
Them that believe. That's all of us. In my name shall they cast out devils.
Yes, sir.
They shall speak with new tongues. How long will stick the house up my mouth? I'm going to tell you something tonight.
Yes.
You can cast the devil out of every loved one you got tonight. If you believe, if you've been saved, you baptized, you full of the Holy Ghost,
amen,
you're going to be able to do it.
Yes.
You can tell the devil, let my people go in the name of Jesus Christ. next line. He's not told me to do it yet. They shall take up serpents. Remember, remember the rod.
Amen.
We'll carry you back to Exodus again now. Remember the rod. God said, told Moses to lay your rod down. He laid it down and it turned into a little serpent. No more snakes. I don't like. He said, pick him up by the tail. He said, pick him up by the tail. He didn't think get down there and play with him, Josh. He said, pick him up by the tail. And when he reached down and picked him up by the tail, it became a rod again.
Yes, it did.
And then when they got there in front of Pharaoh, they told him to lay that rod down again. Whew, he laid it down. Things started slithering again. And then that Pharaoh called his sorcerers and magicians out there, and they laid their rod down, I think about 7 of them. And they started squirming like it. But Josh, all of a sudden, that rod that Moses and them laid down swallowed up every one of them.
Yeah.
They reached down and picked it up by the tail, not by the mouth, by the tail. It turned back into the rod again. Hallelujah to the Lamb. I'm talking about El Shaddai.
Yes, amen.
The God Almighty has put that power in you tonight. And if they drank any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. I don't tell you to go in there and get you a bottle of strychnine and chug a lug it. That's telling you, if you happen up on it and it happens to you, just like the snake bit old Paul in the fire.
Right.
He was a poisonous, venomous snake. He just shook him off.
Amen.
It didn't hurt him. He didn't even swell up. That was such a great thing. Them people on that island thought he was a god.
Yes,
and he had to explain to them that it wasn't.
So.
Oh, they shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. And by just, Jesus has just told you, you've got the power to do everything I've been preaching to you tonight. It's time for Community Chapel, Holiness Church in McGarville, yes, Alabama, to stand up to the devil.
Yes.
And tell him to let our children, our loved ones, go.
Yes.
Tell him don't enter into that door right there no more. It's time to get him out of here.
Amen.
Scripture says, resist the devil and he shall flee from you. Didn't say he wouldn't come back.
Right.
And I'm not telling you how many times that you're going to have to go to that devil and tell him to let my children go. But Moses, he didn't want to go. Moses is just like you and me. When God calls you to do something, you make every excuse in the world not to do it. But I want to tell you something. He's chosen you tonight.
Yes.
To get the devil and let your children go.
Yes.
Tell them, say, the I am that I am sent me in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You've got to let them go. Would you stand, please? They're in the position, come on back up and play something, whatever God laid on your heart to play tonight. The altars are open tonight. I pray that you'll take this message to heart tonight. I believe you will, because I don't believe God was. He said he wouldn't send out his word void. It would always accomplish what it went forth to do.
Amen.
Go with it in your mind tonight and in your heart. The same Jesus that saved you, the same Jesus we've testified tonight about going to the cross for us, is the same Jesus that empowers you. And he's given you the Holy Ghost tonight, and he's empowered you that you can go and tell the devil to let your people go. Amen. Praise God. Praise God.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Leave them there. No matter what comes their way, Achan, We've got to pray that God's going to bring them through it. Because listen, then the Bible says they can enter in lame, they can enter in blind, but they cannot enter in with sin in their lives. Amen. And we got to believe this too, Sister Linda. Abraham, when he took Isaac up on that hillside, that mountain, he had no doubt in his mind, Herman, that he was going to slay Isaac. But he had this in his mind, that God would raise him up from the ashes. Why? Because God said, this is your promised child, not another one. So listen, when God's in control of these things, God knows how to work them out. Amen. Man, what a message tonight. I don't know about y'all, but I'm ready to kick the devil.
Amen.
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 Kick the devil back. Amen. Tell him to get back and don't belong to him. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes, ma'am. Come on up.